I'm Steve Van de Zand. I'm the co-founder of Redline, and welcome to your Redline Milwaukee. Since the 2 years we have been open, we have made some huge gains and huge strides. We opened our doors 2 years ago and invited in 20 artists to take place to work in our professional development program for the duration of 2 years. We are excited that we are starting to have artists leave us and new artists join us. As the first round of artist residencies are coming to an end, we have been fortunate to hit the ground running with a whole array of education programs and to showcase some of the most incredible artwork from around the world over the last 2 years. Here at Redline Milwaukee, the heart truly is our exhibition program. The exhibition program shows 4 shows a year. They're all shows that are based on building social consciousness, not only with the local community, but the community at large. The exhibition really focuses as the heart of Redline. It pumps blood into our 4 other programs, being education, artist and resident professional development, and our community green print shop and paper making studio. Over the past 2 years, we've had 5,000 participants come in through the doorway of education, exhibition, and print shop. We'd like to give a special thank you to Lynn Schumo over at the Haggerty Museum of Art, who built the bridge between us and you to get the technology that's sitting here in front of me. The technology has served many purposes here at Redline, more specifically for our artists in residence and for our education programs. Some of the examples include one of our education programs is a program called Contempo, and that is a night once a month that is designed by 6 of our team residents who have a studio here at Redline. And they are able to invite 30 of their peers in to participate in hands-on activity and talkbacks with exhibiting artists. We've been able to use the technology for those programs to do light animation, pulp animation, flat puppet animation. Our residents have been able to use the technology as they worked with exhibiting artist Rebecca Schoenecker to do animation. The residents also have been able to do editing on Photoshop. They've been able to do editing on Lightbox and all sorts of great stuff to increase and maximize their skills and technique in their work. More importantly, what we require of our artists and residents to stay in studio here is that they do complete 2 hours of community service a week, and having an animator as one of our artists and residents, as an emerging artist, cooked up a project with Roosevelt Middle School of the Arts, and having the technology really allowed the middle school students to come in and participate in the hands-on process of editing, not only building their animated sets and creating their claymation figures, but it allowed them also to take their photographs, download their photographs, and arrange them, put sound and all sorts of effects to the animations to really make them pop.
And now we're going to go down and look at the computer lab. Okay, Steve? Thank you.
Sorts of things happen in here. Earlier I told you how our teams access and what they do in this lab, and how Milwaukee Public School students have used the lab. Right now you can see that there's some art in the lab, and one of our residents actually is working on a show for the gallery where she is in here creating some video work to be projected on a scrim fabric house that talks about shared social spaces.
Very good. Thank you, Steve.